The following program was produced or sponsored by a community member. The content, views, and opinions expressed are the sole responsibility of the producer and do not reflect those of Malden Access Television, the City of Malden, or your cable provider. MATV welcomes your comments. Please call us at 781-321-6400 or email us at access@matv.org.
Third game, the Hawks, winners of 22 straight games, going up against the Kings, 1-5. I'm your host, the Dutch, the Nesta Dudley, Storm and Norman behind the camera, and I'm in the cable cast booth with old friend of the Malden Neighborhood Basketball League, Gary Christensen, City Councilor, Ward 1. And Gary, do you want to make the official announcement on the Malden Neighborhood Basketball League, what your future entails?
Well, let me tell you, no other place I'd rather say it, but I'm a candidate for mayor of the city of Malden than right here at the MNBL.
Put it right there, brother.
All right.
I just want to let you know that as a citizen, okay, that has no affiliation with any other groups, as a citizen, I can do and support whomever I want to. So as a citizen, I support the Christensen ticket.
Well, thank you. And I'll tell you what, it's the MNBL who's helped make me who I am. So a lot of credit goes to you and everything this organization means to the city. This is exactly what we need more of.
Mm-hmm. And you know, Gary, I told you about a good 10 years ago that you were going to be the next mayor. You remember?
In the web.
Yeah,
I was in the web. I don't know what you're going to do to me this Thursday.
Well, we'll be kind to you because, you know, I want to know somebody in the highest office as possible. I want to be on good standings with someone in the highest office as possible in the city. So.
Well, I don't think you need to know me. I think you need to know who's running the Hawks team.
The
22 wins.
22 straight wins.
They
made league history last year. They ran the table. Portrait of a perfect season. 16 straight games when you count the playoffs and the big dance. And they're 6-0 now. 22 straight games, Gary.
And this is all because of my pre-scouting says
Allie Joseph.
Allie Joseph. Allie Joseph. He's the real deal, huh?
Yes, a returner from last year's undefeated championship team. Gary, there's only one person on this team who's not in the house today, but Kyle White is the only person that has ever tasted defeat on the Hawks. The last time the Hawks lost a game, it was 20-9. The last team that beat them was the Kings. The Kings are looking to try to put a bookend marks. The Kings want to give them their first defeat in 22 games.
Well, I know you're always looking to raise money. Here's a perfect fundraiser.
Here's
when
a fundraiser
will the Hawks
right
lose?
Here. When will the Hawks lose? That's actually a question on the ATRLive.com, the MNBL poll. Which team do you think will be the first team to beat the Hawks?
Well, I'll tell you, the Kings didn't look scared in the huddle. They look like they're ready for this.
No, the Kings are going to play with reckless abandon, I would think. They virtually got nothing to lose and everything to gain.
And there was some reckless abandonment, air ball.
Yes.
First shot of the game.
Allie Joseph, that's down low to Jimmy Kedian.
Oh.
Kedian should have taken it himself. Broken up by Dave Fevrin.
That's
12. Bill, you just went over it. That's not the pass.
Now the Hawks put in the 21, the Kings put in the 12. Now I don't know if the 12 is truly a play or if they're just saying the reciprocal of 21.
Well, whatever you're saying, it's not working because they're the Hawks, get the ball back.
They got 10 seconds to get it across the half court.
Wow.
The referees are going to let them play, Gary.
You can tell.
You were here that last game, and there was a lot of smackers of the flesh. A lot of smackers of the flesh that didn't get called. Allie Joseph is quicker than a hiccup.
Oh, what a pass. Great pass. Now, is this one of the fastest players you've ever seen in league history, Allie Joseph?
He is one of the fastest. There have been some very fast players. He's certainly been the fastest player in recent memory. Not to diss Dave Console, if he's listening. Dave Console, track star for Malden High, graduated last year in 2010 when I had both Dave Console and Ali Joseph on Around the Rim last year. You can actually see the link if you go to ATRLive.com, click on 2010 clips. They both admitted that Dave Console was faster than Ali Joseph. And Ali Joseph quicker than a hiccup. So that means Dave Console could probably run up and down the court before you blink your eye.
Oh,
they just have to capitalize on it. Gary, the problem with the Kings is that they do not have a true point guard. They don't have anyone that can handle the rock. The Kings have not had a true point guard since 2007. So they've gone four seasons without a true point guard.
And there was evidence of that right there. I think the center took it in from the top of the key.
And the center and the big man shouldn't be dribbling.
Now, just coming over the wire, it seems like there was a trade happened within the last hour.
There was, I can officially say, because I saw them clapping hands, that there has been a trade. I don't know what the parameters of the trade, but I do know the principal involved, and that's Oliver Georges, OG, formerly of the Sonics, formerly number five of the Sonics. He's going to the Hawks. Going to the Hawks. So when you make a trade like that, when you trade your best player, when you're 1-6, you're basically cashing in the season and you're looking for the draft picks next year.
Oh, look at that. That's highlight reel there.
Oh, yeah, Ali Joseph will get you. He will get you.
I love you, Ali. Careful. Over here.
You cannot dribble through a press. You have to pass through it. First and 10. Speaking about first and 10, Gary, I got it on very good authority that Coach Glenn Higgins has the Steelers tomorrow. Who do you like, Steelers or the Packers?
Packers.
Packers. I'm a Packer guy. Coach Glenn Higgins is a Steelers guy. Got it on good. got it on good authority.
Good job, Johnny. Good job. Tackle.
I'll tell you, for a 22-game undefeated record, you wouldn't know it right now. Hawks only up four.
Hawks only up four right now. They are not at full capacity.
He never made contact. He can.
Oh, there he is.
Here we go. The Hawks will press for the majority of the game.
There he is again.
At that point, I might as well just, it's better just to go out of bounds and turn it over that way instead of give the Hawks an opportunity to score.
Go, go, go. To the middle.
Rejected by Joey Pepe. Joey Pepe, this is his first year on the Hawks, Gary, and I swear he's been on the Hawks before. I'm being joined by Danny Carmona in the cable cast booth. The young man has something to say.
This is a good game. Hawks are doing good. They got a new player, Oliver. He just came from the Sonics, and they're doing good today.
That's the hot news. It's official. Danny Carmona confirmed it. Oliver George has been traded.
Coach Glenn Higgins very upset. Clipboard out.
Yeah, this is going to be a very, very lean year for the Kings. Now, Gary, every year, every first show of the season for Around the Rim, myself and Brad with Benton gives the goings, the pick'ems, the goings and the ain't goings. Okay, I predicted that the teams that were going to go to the playoffs was going to be the Hawks, the Sixers, the Lakers, and the Celtics. Brad predicted it was going to be the Sixers, Lakers, Kings, and Pistons. So Brad did not show any type of respect nor love to a team that had won 16 straight games.
And that's been made public.
Yeah, and that's been made public. Now, I said the big dance was going to come down to the Hawks and the Lakers, for which it was going to be a Laker victory. Brad said it was going to come down to the Lakers and Kings, for which it was going to be a Kings victory. Now, as I'm looking at the official stats coming into this weekend, we see the Hawks on top of the league 6-0, Lakers 4-2, And the Kings, 1-5.
Paltry, 1-5.
That's why you leave the predictions to the professionals, Gary.
Now, I have to assume Joseph in the running for MVP of the league?
Yes, you know what? He was league MVP last year. Or was he playoff MVP? He was either league MVP or playoff MVP because they had Isaiah Kelly last year, who was also an outstanding player. Isaiah Kelly is on the Malden High School basketball team this season.
He's just too fast.
Yes.
He's like a water bug.
This Hawks team have a target on their back. They want all the other seven teams wants to be the first team. All the other seven teams want to be the first team to give the Hawks a blemish.
But for all the hoopla, they're only up 6-0.
Only up 6-0.
Coach Stroud doesn't seem too concerned, hands in pocket.
Yeah, no, he's pretty much chalked this up as a W when he won his game last weekend. He looked at the schedule like, oh, that's a W. But you got to play the games, as you know. That's why we play the games. Hey, if everyone is, that was a nice pass. You have to use the glass. Minutes and one tick left to go in the first. Hawks up by six. Six love.
Has a team ever been shut out in a quarter?
It's happened a couple of times over the 26-year history. Please do not ask me who the teams were and what year. Is everything, Gary, everything just blends. The old memory isn't what it used to be with the stats and the numbers and just 26 seasons, Gary, of the Malden Neighborhood Basketball League.
Unbelievable. Wow. Get that.
Yep. Oh, he was stripped clean. Coach Glenn Higgins didn't want him to stop. He's the tallest man on the court.
Oh.
He stepped on the line.
Oops.
And was that a tease or what?
What?
Ali Joseph right
what
side to
ass.
Right to Joey Pepe. Second violation on the Kings. One minute 56 ticks left to go in the first. And look at this. I think this is a first in Malden Neighborhood Basketball League history in all the 26 years. Oliver George, who was number 5 for the Sonics, played last game against the Lakers. The trade got made just before this game. Now he's number 7 on the Hawks. You asked me at the beginning of the game, was he going to see the court action? I didn't think it was going to happen, but it did.
Someone twice in one day.
Who was the first?
Nesta, that's what you tell us. That's what you say, efficiency.
and he gets in the game and he jacks up a three.
Come on, get a rebound! Don't put it outside!
Okay. I want to know how we did
it.
Alright.
He got hot shoes! He's tired! Go to the middle! There you
go, there you go. Rakeem Knight.
And how are we going to face him? What he does? He's doing what he does!
Oliver George, who had 4 fouls last game, comes in there. Less than 60 ticks, Gary. He's jacked up a three and committed a foul.
And showing the buys, rolling up those sleeves. This could be the Kings' first points.
The ice has been broken. And Gary, Oliver George got taken out. He went on there for less than 60 ticks, jacked up a three, committed a harm, and it got him a one-way ticket to the bench.
Do you think the trade was good for them?
I think that the Hawks have lost one of their weapons. He's going to be not available for the rest of the year. So what they wanted to do, they wanted to replace that player with a comparable player. And the talent between the two players, the Hawks has actually upgraded. I don't think George is not going to be a factor this game. He just got traded to the team. There hasn't been any practices, obviously. Quicker than a hiccup, Allie Joseph. Fevrin's going to take all three of these.
Oh.
Drains it.
Wow.
Their first field goal.
Pressure the ball. Pressure the ball. Woo! No foul. Pressure it.
What was that?
He was fouled right before the buzzer.
Bad foul.
Foul right before the buzzer. It was a tenth of a tick. A tenth of a tick. He couldn't fight back the urge, Gary, for a tenth of a tick.
Coach Hickett's very upset.
All eyes in Malden are on Joey Pepe at the line, where everything is free. Clangs the first one. He's at the line smiling. He has the rabbit ears, the elephant ears. He's hearing what's going on in the stands instead of just focusing on the back of the rim. No follow through and a blown opportunity.
Yeah.
At the end of the first 10, the Hawks are 6 points better than the Kings, 10-4.
So is this what you expected after the first? I think this is a pretty good sign for the Kings.
It's a pretty good sign for the Kings. I mean, the Kings actually scored some points in the first. It's a pretty good sign. To tell you the truth, I actually thought that the score after the end of the first, that the Hawks would be closer to 20. Because they're that good. They're that good. They're that fast. As a team, they're the fastest team we have down here this season. The Hawks do not have a true big man. They do not have any six-footers on the team.
Like a touch the Hawk.
Oh, no one knows.
MNBL doesn't have instant replay.
No, they don't, although we do have the technology, but that means we have to stop recording. And that would just be me doing it, Gary. And I don't want to have extra duties. I do too much anyways. I need help. That's why I'm appreciative that Stormin Norman has been stepping up. This is his first year helping out the Mall Neighborhood Basketball League. Cameraman Stormin Norman.
He's doing a good job.
Doing a damn good job.
Put it up, rebound.
I should have held on to that.
Way to throw the ball blindly like that.
Oh, what a pass.
And Oliver George got right back in the game. I didn't even know he checked back in.
David Fevrin,
I knew he was in there, I could tell. Jacking up the sleeves.
Yes.
It's time to get the feeling. Hawks taking control here.
Oh yeah. They tripled it. They tripled the score of the Kings, 12-4.
Oh.
Blaze the Fevrin. Joseph. That was a nice follow. Couldn't capitalize on that. Well, you know, Gary, if this game gets out of hand, we're going to have to create some conversation. And you know what conversation I always like to create?
Oh, yeah.
The new location, the possible new locations for the City Hall.
Oh,
we've
yeah.
been having this conversation for close to a decade, Gary.
Well, I know whatever we do, we're going to have MATV a part of it.
Yes.
Talk about making things happen. You guys are at every event. Just saw you at Taste of Malden Thursday
night. Taste of Malden. You know, this is they brought back the Taste of Malden. It's the second year of it. But Gary, they have these events on Thursday nights when I have Around the Rim, so I can't partake it.
How dare they?
And no one even brings me a doggy bag or anything like
Tell
that.
You what,
no one
cares. Malekta will create a law.
Okay, there
sure
we go.
That doesn't happen.
Chris, that'll hurt us.
Uh-oh.
Oh, my God.
Here they come. Oh.
Look like we might be having a conversation pretty soon.
I guess that trade was worth it.
They have quadrupled their score. 16-4, combination of 20.
And Nestor, it seems like in the bat of an eyelash. They're up, 12?
They're up 12. The Hawks, they quadrupled their score. The Hawks will do it to you. They got their press. Press broken. Now keep... Foul on George.
Coach Higgins looking for any glimmer of hope.
Yes.
That's 7 fouls on the day. He's been out the game. That's 7. Oh, what the hell?
Coach Higgins, he might be coming back into the booth.
he might be on the receiving end of a technical if he keeps on up.
I know where he lives, I ain't getting a tea.
Get him! Oh!
Wow.
All this lateral movement, they need to go up and down.
Swing it! Come on, Trent.
Turnover. Off to the races.
That's a good job, Jonathan.
Allie Joseph was looking for a foul, didn't get it.
That was good D, John.
That's what I'm talking about. That's all we have. That's all we have. The same lawyer every time, same trick.
Scoring would be nice. They haven't scored all period.
Luis, get out of the way!
She don't get any points for lateral movement.
No.
Stay away from him.
Just hung up there, Gary. They called a jump ball. Believe it or not, Gary, I got Joseph on the jump ball. I'm going with the smaller. I'm serious. I'm going with the smaller man.
All right, let's see.
That was close.
Oh, you got it.
You got that teardrop.
Set it up,
They want to dribble behind their backs, take threes.
We don't need it.
Yes, you do. Thanks, Tiger.
They got to stay off the perimeter.
This keeps up, we might be able to do around the rim right now.
That would save me some time, like I take Thursday night off. Two on two.
Foul on 17.
Never pass the ball behind you when you go into the rack.
Stop dribbling.
Thank you. Whoa.
You gotta wipe your hands, man. You can't be number one.
Thinking there was a little something wrong with his equilibrium.
Good answer. Come on, fight him.
Kings are in the bonus. That's the Hawks' eighth personal foul. Kings will remain in the bonus for the remainder of the half.
Here comes Alejandro. Alejandro.
Come on, Luis, take a shot. Slap. Look up, Jonathan. Who's that?
Certainly bringing up the fouls. I don't know if that's enough to propel him to victory, but.
Hawks are going to that, not the Hawks, Kings. Kings going to the line. They're getting opportunities, Gary,
right,
to come back into this game 1 point at a time, but they're not capitalizing from the line where everything is free.
Which is what makes it exceedingly painful to watch, because they are getting their opportunities. They're just not capitalizing at all.
This is my daughter, Conchesta.
Hello?
All right.
I'll be there in a little, like, you don't have to leave right now, right?
But, I don't know, speak up, what do you say? Oh, do you need the teachers there?
Okay, I'll be right there.
Hawks didn't take a long time in that huddle.
Take your time here, John. 17 minutes.
And I don't know if you can hear him, but Coach Glenn Higgins said it right. One basket and a free throw in 17 minutes of basketball play. But you know what? They just knocked down another basket. Another a point. I should. They added a singular point.
Tanya jumps on rebounds. He jumped 8 feet early.
Come on, kid. Alejandro.
Come on. Oh, that's a steal.
Good thing the ref called that foul, because Higgins, I don't know.
No. He might have lost control. as hot as it is to believe, he probably would have lost control. But the Kings are in a double bonus. That means they're going to be shooting two free throws for the remainder of the half.
Oh,
Knocks it down. They pull to within a third, 18-6. There you go. 1 point at a time, they can climb right back into this game.
Just get in front of them. Don't try to block it.
No way.
Come on, take the rebound.
Good ball. No way.
Turnover.
Hats. Coach Higgins' hat coming off here. Oh. Oh.
Just when the Kings had a good effort, they're down 22-9.
There's your highlight reel for Thursday. Oh. Higgins losing control. Losing control. Oops. There's some swearing there.
Hollering, fussing, and a whole heap of cussing. Meanwhile, Allie Joseph hit a three-pointer. Okay, Gary, this is how the rest of the day is gonna go, Gary. We got 1 minute and 52 ticks left to go. We're gonna finish out this first half. Okay. I am going to leave to pick up my daughter from dancing.
Very
I'm coming
important.
Right back.
Yep.
And then we're gonna talk about possible new locations for City Hall.
That's fine.
And
I'll fill in the ad room for
you. Okay, so.
I'm a veteran. Remember, I've been with you, almost 10 years.
She's over there dancing at the Dance Center School, which is at Maplewood Square, so I'll be right back.
Yep.
Jonas A. pass it to Joseph. Back to Jonas A. He's going to take all three of these. Doesn't get the roll. Berrio down to Pepe with the turnaround. As then go Fevrin with the weak side rebound.
14's hurt, the glasses.
Fevrin, I thought he got slapped.
Yeah, same, I heard it.
I thought his hand got, I heard smackage of the flesh. Coach Higgins is right.
What a hustle. He is the real deal, that Joseph.
Oh yes, quicker than a hiccup. Pandey.
Why are you leaving your feet?
Fevrin is gonna take all three of these. Side rims it. Joseph gonna take all three of these. Bangs it down. Bangs it down. Up by 21, Gary.
This must be a sympathetic timeout.
Back to their score, back to being quadrupled. 28-7 with 7.4 ticks left to go in the first half.
Well, I think Coach Rogers, he called it right. They're either going to win by 5 or lose by 20.
And to tell you the truth, they had no chance at heck of winning by 5. They really didn't. When you've won 22 straight games, you are the heavy favorite. Meanwhile, when your opponent has only won one out of six games. The Hawks are the favorite. No matter every game they play until somebody takes them down, give them an L. The Hawks have not seen an L since the 20-09 season.
That is incredible. The thing that blows me away too, Nestor, is I don't think any of them are over 5'6", 5'7".
It's not a tall team. Not a tall team. They had more of a balanced team last year. This team lives on the perimeter, but they're doing things right because doesn't go. The end of the first half, as I mentioned moments ago, the Kings, the Hawks, have quadrupled the Kings, score 28-7, Gary.
Well, I'll tell you, I've been around this league a long time. I don't think I've ever felt as bad for a team as I did watching the Kings.
If there's one good thing about this, Gary, is that usually when a team gets blown out and you're here, it's usually the Celtics that have your name on the back of their jerseys.
That's one way of looking at it. You're right.
They didn't play today, so they were guaranteed not to lose today.
Well, let me tell you, I did a lot of reading about this Ali Joseph. He is the real deal. MVP-like performance this first half.
For Gary Christensen, City Council, Ward 1. Storm and Norman behind the camera. Nesta Dudley saying we'll see you at the half.
All right. All right, Gary Christensen back at the Ferryway School Gymnasium for game 3 of the Malda Neighborhood Basketball League. I'm here with Stormin Norman behind the camera. I want to thank him for all of his time during the season. And we're watching the Kings and the undefeated Hawks. Scores 28-7 at the half, and we're underway with the Kings with the ball. And the Kings are starting just like they ended, missing the first hoop, second hoop, third hoop, and the Hawks have the ball. And there's a foul by the Kings. Should be a foul. Let's see. Nope. No, they're saying the Hawks were out of bounds. Surprising. Heard a big slap there. All right, so the Kings line up again, down 28-7. Wow, there's a three. There's a three, 28-10 now. Hawks on top. And out of bounds, Hawks ball. And Nesta Dudley had to leave to pick up his daughter. Very admirable, family first. But then again, he looked at the score and he knew, you know, why would I want to stay here? With the Hawks absolutely dominating in the first half. And the way the second half is open, no reason to doubt that. That won't continue. All right, Kings have the ball. Out of bounds. Still Kings ball.
Eric Whistle.
All right, once again, 28-10. Hawks on a 22-game winning streak. There's a lot of hopping. Kings miss. Hawks have the ball. Oh, what a pass. Half-court pass from the newly acquired George. He was just traded prior to the game, and he's already making his impact felt. That beautiful pass. There he is again with a board. Oliver George. Touch pass, 15. Ali Joseph, and the wheels have come undone at the Ferryway School Gymnasium, where the Hawks are just dominating. 32-10, and they steal it. George gets fouled, but he's okay, no band-aid required, like his previous game. Ali Joseph inbounds it. George takes it, rolls up his sleeves, wants the ball. Ali Joseph says, you know what, I'm going to go to Pepe this time. Why not? Well, that's about the only thing the Hawks have done wrong today. 3-second violation.
your time.
Once again, I'm Gary Christensen, Malden City Councilor, and we're here at the Fairway School Gymnasium where the Kings just threw up a three. No shot, but there's a foul. That stalls the pain of this crushing lead by the Hawks temporarily. The way things are going, we won't even need a cameraman. I might have Storm and Norman come back here with me because the Hawks are just rolling. There's a three hoisted by the Kings, but to no avail. Here come the Hawks. And another bucket, it looks like, coming up. Yep, Pepe. Pepe, this is just a clinic now. Oh. There's a little bit of hope for the Kings. They get the rebound and hit the shot. The free throw is missed. Pepe with the rebound. Another indication of how this game is going is the usually boisterous Coach Higgins is on the bench, arms folded. He knows we're in for a long day today, so he's resting up for the rest of his weekend.
Gotta stay on your feet, Bill. No need to jump.
All right, first free throw by the Hawks is good. And the second one coming up. And that's good. So once again, the Hawks, 36 to 12 with 4 minutes, 30 seconds left, third quarter. And a steal by Allie Joseph. Allie Joseph coast to coast, but just couldn't finish it off.
Johnny, you got a pass, kid. You don't have to move any time to collapse. Hey, 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 hey,
hey, hey, and another steal, Joe Pepe. All right, we have a foul, Hawks ball. What else?
Jonathan.
George with the three, feeling it.
Good job, Jeff. Take your time.
He got bailed out, I think. Kings go up. There's what you call a brick. No net, no rim on that one. And it hits it off the backboard. So we have 36-13 Hawks over the Kings. 3 minutes left in the third quarter. Oh, what a move. Travel. Beautiful pass by Allie Joseph, but just couldn't finish.
Good play.
All right, number one goes up and gets fouled.
Nice and slow.
Foul was on Oliver George, otherwise known as OG. All right, rebound by the Kings. Nope, Hawks. White ball off of Oliver George. Okay, shot up by the Kings, no good. Kings get the rebound. Hawks strip it. There's a melee on the floor. Jump ball. Okay, once again, I'm Gary Christensen, Malden City Councilor, coming to you live from the Ferryway School Gymnasium, where the Hawks lead the Kings 36-13. Mayor with Storm and Norman behind the camera. And a vacant chair to my left, Nestor Dudley, who had to pick up his daughter. And he should be back very shortly. But he's not missing much as the Hawks continue to plaster the Kings 36-13. There's a foul on Oliver George.
17.
I'm wondering the way things going if they might just let the clock run. Because this is just a thrashing. Right, Storm and Norman? He agrees. Yeah. All right, 2 minutes left in the third, 37-13, Hawks over the Kings. All right, the Hawks starters. They're going to get a reprieve. It's 1 minute, 53 seconds left in the third quarter. Who can blame them? Nice pass by the Kings. Beautiful. But a little too late. Jump ball. All right, the Hawks and Kings will jump it up. And I think we have a highlight reel as the tap went to a King. King put it in the Hawks hoop. So I don't know if that's ever been done before. At least I haven't seen it in a long time. But quite amusing in an otherwise dour game. Hawks have the ball. We're just about out of this merciful quarter. Wow, hook shot. Everything going right for the Hawks today. Wow. Number five just redeemed himself a little bit with that three.
If it's not in there, let me know. I'll ask Kenny.
All right, the quarter's over, 41-18. Those of you just tuning in for the first time have witnessed, you are witnessing an absolute bashing by the Hawks over the Kings. And I always look at the huddles as a sign of what's to come. Speaking of about to come, here is Nesta Dudley back in the booth. Very happy to have him back, although based on the score, he didn't need to come back.
I can tell you, Gary, I came as swiftly as I possibly could, but I was outside for over 5 minutes because the bloody front door is locked.
But so Nesta, you did not miss a thing. Look at the scoreboard.
41-18. Although you could say that the Kings went on a bit of a run because when I left, the score was 28-7. So at least they scored 11 points in 10 minutes.
And it might have been 13 except number five put the ball.
Scored for the other team? Oh, boy.
So I'm thinking that'll be on the highlight
reel. Yes, I'm thinking so too. Free throw line is.
Ladies and gentlemen, I can always tell how a team's doing by their coaches, and I see Coach Rogers kind of just staring off into space. I see Coach Higgins with his hands in his pocket. This is just a pounding by the Hawks.
Well, Coach Rogers knew that this season was going to be a lean season, and he knew that didn't really have good chances in today's contest, and we know for a fact that a player quit in the first half, which happened to be the best player on the team.
So there you go.
Yes, it's just. The only thing that's left to do is talk about future possible locations for the new City Hall.
Well, let me say, the reception out there has been great. The good news so far in my 90 days on the trail is the a lot of people think the city has a great deal of potential. So that's good to hear.
Yes.
And, you know, I think people are looking for City Hall to be more customer service friendly.
Mm-hmm.
Start trying to include a lot more of the groups that have come into Malden, like our Muslim population and Haitian American. And so I'm trying to reach out and see if, you know, make sure that they know there's a role for them in the city of Malden going forward. So can't do much for them on getting rid of taxes, though.
No, there's only two things that are sure: death and taxes.
But you know, the other thing that surprised me so far is everywhere I've gone, I think the people are hoping we'll do a lot more with our teams going forward, building on what the MNBL has done year round.
Yeah.
So. And I know the MNBL has expanded. They now have their very own summer league.
Yes, last season was the first season of it down to Greens at the newly renovated Green Street Park.
That's right.
And I was there one time. I was there for maybe the first period or something like that. It's the only time I just went there just to say that I was there. In the summer league. Matter of fact, I had seen you at the car show after the league was over, and I said, you know, Gary, I do so much with the league. It's like, you know, they don't need me around in the summer. Go forth and just take advantage of the opportunity you have of playing summer basketball.
Well, it was actually a good move because I was forced to, first time ever, learn how to record, do the book. But you know, the other things people have told me, we got to communicate more, you know, try to use every tool out there to make sure people know what's going on. So that includes Facebook, Twitter, online forums, everything.
All the social media.
Yeah, everything. Got to use every tool to get to them. Because I don't think people, you know, they lead busy lives, but they want to know what's going on.
Mm-hmm.
So we got to try and do something with that.
I know that for a fact that you email your constituents in Ward 1.
Yep.
So I know
every,
that for a fact.
Every 3 weeks since 2004. And let me tell you, Nesta, what a great tool it is, because at least people can walk around town kind of having an idea of what's going on.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, what was that? It was a mugging.
So now, if you are fortunate enough to be elected mayor, would the email of the constituents expand to the entire city?
Absolutely, unequivocally. I think I see myself using that, Facebook, Twitter, online forums where people can meet me and ask questions online, using Skype, and then I'm going to work remotely. You know, one day I might set up shop at MATV, who knows?
Well,
I don't need to be in City Hall.
Well, MATV is Malden's media center, so.
Making things happen.
Stay on your feet.
That's the only thing the Kings have.
Yeah, that's the only highlight. The Hawks are 4 minutes and 40 ticks away from winning their 23rd straight game.
Is there a mercy rule?
No. There's no mercy rule. But you know what? The Hawks bench is in there. Like, I don't see Ali Joseph in there. I don't see Oliver George's in there. So this is the bench that's maintaining the lead.
Yep, they took them out early, third quarter. Back to that idea of doing more with the teens, you know, I think some folks have asked that we, you know, try and establish a teen center from, you know, the hours of 2 to 9, 2 to 10, something like that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, a lot of our programs now, they're 2 to 4, two to five. We gotta expand that.
Well, where could a site for that be?
Well, maybe doing something jointly with the YMCA, YWCA, Partnership for Community Schools, joint effort.
Yeah.
Because they have the space.
Yes.
The YM does.
Yes.
For sure.
Yes. How old is that new YMCA?
It's gonna be 6 years.
Yeah.
5 years, something like that.
I've only been in there once and never even had a tour.
Beautiful facility, wow. And then, you know, we have a lot of issues, challenges with crime. So we got to try and get smarter there using technology. That's the leaps, you know, we got to use technology to its fullest and we got to become, you know, more efficient. I wrote a report with a couple of my colleagues in 2009. I mean,
King Ball, hustle down.
You don't even have voicemail.
Wow. And voicemail, that's 20th century technology.
Yeah.
And we're in the 21st century,
yeah.
So.
Uh-oh.
Well, all this is sounding good to me.
Well, you know me, I'm a doer, you know. And if things happen, I'm just going to be very aggressive on trying to compete with these cities and towns around us to be the best we can be.
Yes.
Oh, nice shot.
Now, I know a dream of Mayor Howard's, and I'm sure that you agree with the dream and will continue the dream, but I could be wrong, but I'm sure you will, is that he wanted to see the city connected via fiber. So that means we can go live from multiple drops in the city. Like, personally, I would like to see a fiber connection from the present City Hall chambers to MATV. With a fiber connection and with better cameras and stuff, it'll be a clearer picture. But with a fiber connection, we can actually program that into our Telview, which is our server. So when we go live, it won't be that hard cut of signal. I know that you're usually in the chamber booth, so you're not seeing when it goes live, but when it goes live on the with the existing technology, it's a hard cut in the signal, so you see video snow for like a second.
Yeah.
But that was just based on technologies from the late, from the mid to late 80s.
Right.
But now with the fiberglass, with the fiber connection, there's a fiber connection from the senior center to MATV. So whenever we record live events from the senior center, it's a seamless go live and go and go offline.
We have one meeting there.
Yes.
That was beautiful.
Yes. So you know, I would like to see fiber. Well, I know plans are on the works to have a fiber connection from the Jenkins Auditorium to MATV.
Yep.
So I know that Mayor Howard wanted to see that come true, and you know, he is going to be the outgoing mayor, so all these things are not going to happen under his administration, but I would just hope that this would be one of the goals under the Christensen administration.
It definitely will be. I'm going to be very aggressive with technology. As a matter of fact, I'd love to try and pick up the idea of us going wireless across the city. You know, 80% of our students, you know, can't get online. If we could do that, you wouldn't need the big backpacks, textbooks, all that stuff.
Mm-hmm. Now, I know Anthony Rodriguez, who is the city IT, I know it's his dream to have the city like a wireless grid of it. So,
yep.
Yeah, so.
We need to do it if we want that competitive edge.
Mm-hmm.
And then we really got to do more with the small businesses in the city.
Yes.
I'm going to be very aggressive on making sure they have a role in what it is we do, because we can't turn to the federal government anymore. The state government's out of money.
Yep.
You got to get business. It's all about business.
Yep.
And apparently it's all about the Hawks. I'm going to get them in the administration. They seem to have figured it out. This is just a thrashing. Hey, they're just giddy on the Hawks bench, Nesta.
Oh, yes. Well, you know, when you're about to win your 23rd straight game.
Wow.
The Hawks' next opponent, which is the Celtics, the team that wears your name on the back of their jersey, that's going to be in tomorrow's non-cable cast game.
And what's the opening line there, Nesta?
Opening line. Hawks are favored until they lose. Opening nine, Hawks by 12. But the Celtics are like this, you know, some games they play brilliantly and they can hang with the upper echelons of the Long Neighborhood Basketball League. Another game they just played terribly. The Sonics got their last win. They got their first and only win last Sunday against the Celtics. The Celtics are playing 500 ball. They're 3-3.
Yeah.
So the Celtics are in the mix.
And they're coached by?
They're coached by Mighty Joe Young.
Oh, yeah. Good coach. A lot of respect for him. Yeah. Oops. I don't know what that was.
You play until the whistle. Drains it. They play until the whistle. Like, if I'm the Hawks coaches, I don't care. You've doubled their score. You're going to win your 23rd straight game.
I don't think even the bench has broken a sweat.
They're swinging around the perimeter, the Hawks. Inside, got swatted cleanly, stays down here. 38 ticks exactly left to go in this game. 38 ticks away from 23rd straight victory. That was a nice pass.
Oh, wow.
Ravi Pandey.
That's how to cut to the hole, Ravi.
Time to get in position, Gary. Hawks 50, Kings 28, Hawks' last defeat came to the Kings team back in 20-09. History is not going to repeat itself on this occasion. Hawks victorious, 23rd straight victory.
Yeah, you had warned me that the Hawks were the real deal, and they showed it today. I really should have brought a book or the soloist.
You should have brought the soloist, yeah. Yes. We're going to talk about the soloist. Malden Reed's One City, One Book.
Right. Just a total thrashing by the Hawks.
So we'll see you this week on Around the Rim.
Yep.
Now, we are 30 minutes earlier, so we're going on at 7 o'clock.
I'll be there.
7 o'clock, so I can get you there anytime between 6:30 and quarter to 7. It'll be a beautiful thing.
Looking forward.
Okay. For Gary Christensen, City Councilor, Ward 1. Earlier, Bradworth Benton, who's always representing. Storm and Norman behind the cablecast booth. I am your host, Dudson, saying we'll be seeing you at the games.
All right.